In the world of business, the rule of thumb is that bigger is better. In American retail, companies embrace this saying like a truth. The bigger the store you have, the more goods and services you can sell, and the more money that you'll make. If you think of some of the leading American retail companies like Walmart, Target, and Costco, their stores are built like cathedrals, and they just keep getting bigger. Retail, at its most abstract, is the heartbeat that fuels the domestic consumption, which in turn drives the whole American economy forward. When in doubt, just keep printing. But what happens when that consumption, spending, and money printing finally catches up? I think we're starting to see some of that now. 15% inflation, the highest increase in prices since the 1980s, $8 a gallon for gas in some cities, shipping delays, supply chain problems, labor shortages, and so forth. When I shipped a 40-foot container of goods from China to the West Coast 3 years ago during the Great Trade War, it cost around $2,500. Well, $3,000 if you include the 25% tariff I had to pay to the Trump administration. But nowadays, it costs $20,000 to ship that same container from China to the West Coast. On top of that, we have a semiconductor shortage, where car manufacturers are cutting production, used car prices are hitting record levels, and buying a used car nowadays is just as expensive as buying a new car. There's enough sticker shock just going to the grocery store these days and putting steak in your cart. And prices just seem to be getting higher and higher. Throw in the fact that the stock market is now crashing back to pre-COVID prices, and many consumers, myself included, are now looking for discounts and deals in a world that no longer seems to offer any. There is one Fortune 500 company that, despite the supply chain issues, the labor shortages, this 15% inflation, and the rising gas costs, that is so committed to giving you a discount that it puts the discount in their name. That company is the Dollar Tree. Dollar Tree doesn't rely on any of the traditional retail playbooks. There's no flashy white lighting or minimalism decor, no modern sans serif branding, and no marketing to millennials. Instead, the Dollar Tree is focused on one mission: to become the retail monopoly of low-class America. Dollar Tree's vicious conquest of low-income and rural America has been so successful that the company has found itself in political hot water. Cities, small towns, and rural communities in New Orleans, Kansas City, and Alabama have all united together to ban Dollar Tree from opening more stores in their neighborhoods. From the outside, the Dollar Tree is a fun, harmless store where you go to buy random, gimmicky, short-lived products for a buck. But go inside, and the Dollar Tree is a ruthless business empire who knows that its best customers are low-income Americans. The company will do everything it can to suffocate the competition and to be the only store physically available in low-income communities, small towns, and rural America. So poor Americans keep buying Dollar Tree, no matter how flimsy or low quality its products may be, because there's just no other store around that they can afford or is available in their neighborhood. But let's take a step back and zoom out first to understand what Dollar Tree is as a company. Dollar Tree operates exclusively in North America under two brands, Dollar Tree and Family Dollar. When you walk into a Dollar Tree, the store is true to its name. The price ceiling at Dollar Tree is strictly defined in every state that it operates, where everything is sold for at most $1. Most things in a Dollar Tree sell for exactly $1, no matter what state you're in, but some things are certainly less. But not even Dollar Tree can escape inflation and rising supply costs. The company recently increased its price cap by 25 cents, much to intense backlash, so products now are priced at $1.25 and not just a dollar. Still, this is the first time that the Dollar Tree has raised its prices in 35 years. Dollar Tree stores on average are about 8,000 to 10,000 square feet, which is about the same size of a Trader Joe's or Apple store. 60% of products sold at Dollar Tree are purchased domestically and 40% are imported from overseas. The theory here is that everything is still manufactured overseas for cheap and in bulk, whether that's factories in China, Mexico, Taiwan, or India. The only difference here is that Dollar Tree isn't the one working with the factories. Dollar Tree greatly prefers doing business with domestic US-based distributors. The distributors are the people who directly interface and deal with the companies overseas, and in doing so, they help Dollar Tree reduce their supply chain complexity, and they minimize any optics that the company would suffer from being overly dependent on exports. If you can't even get custom t-shirts in America these days printed for less than $10-$15 a shirt, you can be sure that there's no factory in the US that's manufacturing keychains, toys, and toothpicks for less than a dollar. Birthday cards, sticky notes, and other paper products, sure, you can find that in America for really cheap, but not everything else. The Dollar Tree sells three main types of products. The first type is consumable merchandise, which is everyday goods like candy, food, health and beauty, household supplies, and chemicals. Consumable merchandise used to be the best-selling product type and historically has made up nearly 50% of Dollar Tree's annual revenue. The second product category is variety merchandise, which the company defines as toys, houseware, gifts, stationery, party goods, greeting cards, clothes, or blankets. Variety merchandise is currently the best-selling product at Dollar Tree and makes up 49% of their annual revenue. The third product type is seasonal goods, which are Valentine's Day, Easter, Halloween, and Christmas merchandise. Seasonal goods have been the weakest contributor to Dollar Tree's top line, making up only 5-6% of the company's annual gross revenue for the past 3 years. There are about 8,000 Dollar Tree stores across the United States and Canada. Texas, Florida, and California are the states with the most Dollar Tree locations, with over 600 Dollar Tree stores in each of those states. To put into perspective just how widespread the Dollar Tree is, there are almost as many Dollar Tree stores as there are Walgreens in the United States alone. Here's another way to visualize it. For every two Starbucks or McDonald's that exists, there is one Dollar Tree. Or, for every Chipotle that you pass, there are three Dollar Trees that exist. For every Trader Joe's that you see, there are also 15 Dollar Tree stores. There are seven times as many Dollar Tree stores as there are Kroger or Publix supermarkets. Dollar Tree stores, by design, are meant to feel small and efficient. The goal is to make consumers feel like they can pop into the Dollar Tree, buy something quickly, and get out without feeling overwhelmed. This is the complete opposite of the traditional retail playbook. A typical Walmart or Target clocks in about 150,000 square feet, which is about 15 times the size of a Dollar Tree. When you walk into a Walmart, a Target, a Costco, a Kroger's, what's happening is that those stores actually want you to get lost. They design their stores like mazes where they put milk and other essentials all the way in the back, so that you have to walk through the store and you get distracted by all the displays and promotions. You go through these colorful, never-ending aisles of brands and merchandise, all in a way so that you end up buying more than what you intended to. In the future, when you're running up and down aisles and you're having trouble finding something at Target or Walmart, know that this frustrating shopping experience is actually intentional. Dollar Tree's goal is to make it easy for consumers in comparison to shop and encourage fast repeat trips for small items. The other core aspect to the Dollar Tree's shopping experience is the treasure hunt. When you go to a Target, a Walmart, or Kroger's, or a local bodega or supermarket, all these stores are optimized to be risk-averse. They optimize for consistency, availability, and predictability. Retailers know that consumers are looking for things like Gillette razors, Sara Lee cake mixes, Ben & Jerry's ice cream, Oscar Mayer hot dogs, Charmin toilet paper, and other essentials from reputable brands. The brands and products that you see at these large retailers generally don't change. If a new product is introduced, these stores will only roll it out very slowly in small quantities to test their demand. Retailers, even if it's the local bodega or supermarket, will never risk their valuable shelf space to carry new products or brands unless the demand is clear and obvious. This is fundamentally why it's so hard for new CPG or consumer packaged good companies to get their products on the shelves of retailers. But Dollar Tree, once again, is the opposite. They optimize for unpredictability and serendipity. Their products are constantly changing, which means that shoppers can find something new at Dollar Tree on each trip. This treasure hunt experience adds FOMO, freshness, and urgency in a way where shoppers are incentivized to buy the products that stand out to them as soon as they see them, as there's no guarantee that they'll be stocked again in the future. Dollar Tree stores, generally speaking, are also disorganized, bare bones, and pretty messy. Shoppers are encouraged to be proactive in finding the best deal or rare products by tearing open the boxes, moving inventory, and digging around piles and messy aisles, all in the name of getting the most value out of their buck. This treasure hunt shopping experience is the quote-unquote charm of the Dollar Tree that keeps consumers hooked. This is just the first brand, Dollar Tree. Now let's get into the second brand, Family Dollar. Family Dollar is a complementary store to Dollar Tree, and it positions itself as a neighborhood discount store. Products at Family Dollar stores sell for at most $10, with most products on sale for less. Interestingly enough, Family Dollar stores are smaller than Dollar Tree stores. Family Dollar stores range about 6,000 to 8,000 square feet. And whereas most products at Dollar Tree are not branded, Family Dollar offers leading brands and private label products. Family Dollar offers a wide variety with four main product types. The first is, again, consumable merchandise, which is food, beverages, tobacco, health and beauty, household chemicals, paper products, hardware supplies, diapers, batteries, and pet food. The second category is home products, so things like houseware, home decor, giftware, comforters, sheets, and towels. The third category is apparel and accessories, so things like clothing, fashion, and even shoes are carried at Family Dollar. And the last is electronics and seasonal merchandise for Valentine's Day, Easter, Halloween, and Christmas. Consumables are Family Dollar's best-selling products, and they make up over 75% of its sales for the past 3 years. Seasonal merchandise and electronics, on the other hand, make up only 9%. Apparel accounts for 6%, and home products make up only 8% of Family Dollar's annual net sales. There are about 8,000 Family Dollar stores in the U.S. Texas, Florida, and Ohio are the states with the most Family Dollar stores. Even though both Dollar Tree and Family Dollar target low-income Americans, the two brands are designed to be strategic complements to one another. To prevent sales cannibalism, Dollar Tree operates more in the suburbs, whereas Family Dollar operates in the rural and low-income urban communities. Total annual sales for Dollar Tree in 2021 was $26 billion across 16,000 stores. Compared to other retail heavyweights, Dollar Tree's overall top-line revenue and earning potential doesn't seem all that great. In comparison, Target grosses around $90 billion every year with less than 2,000 stores. The average Target store makes $49 to $50 million per year. Walmart US, on the other hand, grosses $370 billion with less than 5,000 stores nationwide, and the average Walmart store makes about $78 million. Both Target and Walmart are also much farther ahead than Dollar Tree when it comes to technology, online ordering, and delivery. But like most things in life, the devil is in the details. The average Dollar Tree store grosses $1.7 million a year. So what Dollar Tree lacks in size and scale, it does make up for in margin. The company's annual gross margin hovers at 30%, with a COGS of 70%. That means that for every product that Dollar Tree sells for $1, the product cost is 70 cents and the company pockets 30 cents as gross profit. If you were to repeat the same exercise with Target and Walmart, the numbers are actually fairly interesting. Despite having much larger stores, greater inventory diversity, a much bigger brand, a broader customer base, and a higher sales volume, Walmart's annual gross margin is only 24% with a COGS of 76%. Target's gross margin, on the other hand, is similar. It's remained steady at 28% with a COGS of 72%. But here's where we can go more into exploring the big retailers. Target and Walmart are both extremely successful and massive retailers that are known as anchor tenants. If you're a landlord, getting Target or Walmart into your shopping center as an anchor tenant can single-handedly turn your shopping mall from failing to thriving. You generally want to give them a very generous, cheap multi-year lease because of how much they bring to the table. On the other hand, if you're a CPG company and you want to get your products on the shelf of a Walmart or a Target, you know that's going to unlock massive reach, brand credibility, and consistent revenue. Because of how much Target and Walmart have to offer, suppliers, both in real estate and in products, are more than happy to give them massive discounts in exchange for steady cash flow and customer reach. But even though there is this dynamic, Target and Walmart just can't get their product costs as low as Dollar Tree. 2 to 6% difference in COGS might not seem like much, but in the world of retail where margins are tight and every penny matters, a single percentage point in any direction is significant. The other aspect to compare here is an expansion. Target and Walmart and other big retailers are like mammoths. Each store is massive and clock in at hundreds and thousands of square feet in order to be able to carry every product that someone would want throughout their life. Because of how big these retailers' stores are, it makes their expansion inherently difficult. When Walmart and Target and Costco are thinking about a place to go to, they have to find a space that's not only big enough for them to operate in, but they'll also need all the surrounding to support it. They need the parking spaces, the parking lots, and proximity to major highways for their trucks to easily access and unload cargo to. On top of that, these large retailers need large towns or urban areas with high population density that have enough sufficient daily consumer demand to make that one store profitable. Because the cost of expansion is so expensive, these big retailers move really slowly and carefully when it comes to opening new locations. Target has only opened 58 new stores in the past 3 years, or 19 new locations on average every year. Walmart, on the other hand, in the past 3 years has actually decreased the number of stores it has opened. It's closed down 27 stores in the US in the past 3 years, and hasn't dared to open another one. In comparison, the Dollar Tree over the same 3 years has opened 700 new stores in the US alone. The hare and the tortoise is a tale as old as time about how being faster, more nimble, and lean doesn't necessarily beat the slow and steady. This same moral has been applied religiously in the world of retail, along with the rule of thumb that bigger is better. But with the world going through this 15% inflation, supply chain shortages, record transportation costs, interest rate hikes, and lower consumer spending, this just might be Dollar Tree as the hair is turned to shine as the next biggest name in retail.